Hello.
Hello.
Good evening. Three times. Had to have been a real blessing today to hear all these wonderful groups and singing their hearts out and drumming and playing instruments. A real blessing to have folks like this that will come and speak to our hearts and our music and use the power of God's giving. You know, we have the opportunity to praise the Lord many times, and the song's not going to do tonight. First one I start on, it's not a stringed instrument, it's a wind instrument, but as mentioned in the Bible many times, the trumpet of the Lord. And so I'm going to play that now, and the song just says simply to, let there be praise, let there be joy in your heart, sing to the Lord, and give Him glory. Amen. Saved, she was taking care of newborns because it was 3 years old, and she would teach them, and also she would just show them the things that, are going on in the world, and teach them about what Jesus was about. But the phone would ring, and she started getting some phone calls. It was, one of these crank calls, someone that was doing bad things on the phone. So she got to the point where she would, before she answered the phone, she'd say, "Praise the Lord," before she answered, just to rebuke the devil and, put the Lord in place there. And so one day the parents of one of these little kids picked her kid up that evening, and she said, "There's something strange going on. Whenever the phone rings at home," and these are 1, 2, 3-year-olds, they can't really talk anyway. But anyway, they said, "She says something, we don't know what it is." So that little child was saying, "Praise the Lord," every time the phone rang in that house, which I don't know whether they were Christians or not, but Jeannie's ministry was strong for those families that had newborns, probably first child that they had. But I'm thankful that we can praise the Lord. And we need to remember that there's days coming where it's going to be tough to praise the Lord, but we still need to do it no matter what. So listen to this song as it says, "I'll praise the Lamb."
Oh,
You ever thought about what would happen if God said no? Well, we know he didn't, but what if God said no to us? What would that be like? Well, this song is called, it says, "He Said Yes." And I'm thankful today that he said yes. For me, for you, for this community, for the world, he said yes. We just need to be seen. What would it take for God to say no? What would it take to let me go? What would it take for God to say no to his love? Where can I hide from his face? Where can I run from his grace? What would it take for God to say no to his love? He'd have to say no to Adam's race. He'd have to say no to Abraham's face. He'd have to say no to his promised grace. He'd have to say no. He'd have to say no to the angel's voice. Never would have heard the shepherds rejoice. He'd have to say no to the Son of the grace. He'd have to say no. He'd have to say no to 33 years. He'd have to say no to the blood and the tears. He'd have to say no to the O'Brien cross. He'd have to say no. He'd have to say no, disciples and friends. He'd have to say no to coming again. He'd have to say no. He'd have to say no. He'd have to say no. What loving God we have. Loving God we have. He holds us in his hands every day. He carries us through the trials, through the times in our lives. Sometimes it's very difficult. And some of you are going through health issues, financial issues, family issues, relationships. But God's there because he said yes to us. You need to say yes to him. Receive him in your heart, your life. Let him change you. Let him transform you. Make you new. That's what the Bible says. What God tells us in his word. He'll renew us. We need to renew our minds and just cling to God's word. I have a friend, a pastor actually, said God's word, it's the wisdom of God, it's the revelation of God, and it's the will of God. And we need to cling to it. And he also says that the Bible is the most important possession that you own. No matter what kind of car you have, what kind of house you have, the Bible is more important. It worth more than any of those items in your life. I'm going to do a song now. I'm going to change the instrument here. This one was a trumpet. And it's a B-flat instrument. This one is called a flugelhorn. Flugelhorn. And the only difference between the two is this one didn't go on a diet. It's fatter. It gives you a more mellow sound. So that's why, on the way I know it, it's more mellow. This song is one that we all know very, very well. And I'm thankful for God's amazing grace. Amen. Thank you so much. God bless each and every one of you. It's been a privilege and a pleasure to be a part of this tonight and stay with God. Loves us so much, He gives us the opportunities to do what only He can have us to do. Thank you.
Praise God, that was wonderful. I'd love to hear that trumpet resonate in here. And one of these days soon, I believe we're going to hear a trumpet. I believe the Lord's going to, the sound of the trumpet's going to sound.